You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is Saturday, the 9th of October, 2021, 27th week in ordinary time. And today we remember St. Denis, Bishop and Companions, Martyrs. St. Denis is the patron saint of France, and in particular of Paris, where, as the first bishop, he organized a church and proclaimed the gospel. During Valerian's persecutions in 250, he was martyred along with two clerics. We pray for France. We pray especially for Paris, that Christian faith may be revived through this great saint, the first bishop of Paris. Let us pray. O God, who sent Saint Denis and his companions to preach your glory to the nations and strengthen them for their mission with the virtue of constancy in suffering, grant, we pray, that we may imitate them in disdaining prosperity in this world and in being undaunted by any trial. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Our first reading will be taken by Mary Mutimbusia, celebrating her birthday today, a Daily Bread member from Lilongwe, Malawi.
First reading, a reading from the book of the prophet Joel, Joel chapter 3, verses 12 to 21. Put in the sickle, because the harvest is ripe. Thus says the Lord, let the nations bestir themselves and come up to the valley of Josaphat, for there I will sit to judge all the nations round about. Put in the sickle, for the harvest is ripe. Go in, tread, and the winepress is full. The vast overflow for their wickedness is great. Multitudes, multitudes in the valley of decision, for the day of the Lord is near in the valley of decision. The sun and the moon are darkened, and the stars withdraw their shining. And the Lord roars from Zion, and utters his voice from Jerusalem, and the heavens and the earth shake. But the Lord is a refuge to his people, a stronghold to the people of Israel. So you shall know that I am the Lord your God, who dwell in Zion, my holy mountain. And Jerusalem shall be holy, and strangers shall never again pass through it. And in that day the mountains shall drip sweet wine, and in the hills shall flow with milk. And all the stream beds of Judah shall flow with water, and a fountain shall come forth from the house of the Lord, and water the valley of Shittim. Egypt shall become a desolation, and Edom a desolate wilderness, for the violence done to the people of Judah, because they have shed innocent blood in their land. But Judah shall be inhabitant forever, and Jerusalem to all generations. I will avenge their blood, and I will not clear the guilt. For the Lord dwells in Zion. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our gospel passage will be taken by Father Oscar Simbarashe Musa, a Daily Bread member and a Salesian of Don Bosco, working in Wange, Zimbabwe.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Luke chapter 11, verses 27 to 28. At that time, as Jesus was speaking, a woman in the crowd raised her voice and said to him, "Blessed is the womb that bore you and the breasts that you sucked." But he said, "Blessed rather are those who hear the word of God and keep it." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
After encouraging the people to fast, to pray, because of the many things that had befallen them, because of the locust inversion that made people think that it was God punishing them for their unfaithfulness to God, and after telling them all this, now he starts talking about restoration, that God is going to restore. Oh, how we want that restoration to occur in our lives. How we want God to come and intervene and show his love. And Joel, the Hebrew name that means God is Yoh. And Yoh is the short form for Yahweh. God is Yahweh. God is the Lord. And there is no other. And this is exactly what Joel preaches. He preaches his name to the people. He says, "For the day of the Lord is near in the valley of decision." And what will happen when the Lord, who is God, comes to take over? The sun and the moon is going to be darkened. And the stars withdraw their shining. Wait a minute. What has that to do with the coming of the Lord? Why should he be talking about the sun and the moon? He is saying this because many people had strayed from the true worship of God, and they started worshiping nature. They started worshiping the God of the sun, the God of the moon, the God of the stars. They started following other gods. And Joel says the day is coming when these will be brought to nothing, when these will have no effect on humanity. The sun and the moon will be darkened. Remember how the Romans, even many years later, would consider the sun as God. That even they had kept the day when to worship that sun. It is on sun day. On the day of the sun, they would worship the sun because it was a god. And Christianity came and took up that. Why? Because the Lord decided to come back to life on Sunday, the first day of the week, the day of the sun, because he is the light of the world. Because he's the light, he replaces that worship of the sun and he becomes the real light to the people. And we worship on a Sunday tomorrow, because we know that the real sun is not that sun which can be darkened, but God, whose light can never be darkened, the owner of everything. It is because of this that we are able even to celebrate Christmas. Christmas is celebrated on the 25th of December, when the Romans used to celebrate the birthday of the sun. Now, who is our sun to us? Who is the light of the world? Christ himself. So, for us, nature is not God. God himself is God. And so we worship on the day of the sun. And so we celebrate on the birthday of the Son of God. So you may ask and say, where is it written that Christmas is on the 25th of December? Now you have the background and you understand when you are getting into that church, we have God as our light. Because he's our light, he's our true sun, anything else can be darkened, but he will never be darkened. Any other force, any other power can be darkened, but our God remains our God. And so he says when he visits his people, when his day comes, he's going to make the sun and the moon get darkened, and the stars will withdraw their shining. The Lord will be our light. The Lord is going to be the refuge for the people. When they are afraid, seeing the sun getting darkened, seeing the moon getting darkened, what happens when there is no sun and there is no moon? There is total darkness. And when there is total darkness, fear creeps in. We want to look for somewhere to run to. We become refugees. If we become refugees, we have to look for a refugee center. God is our refuge. God is the one we run to. God is the one we seek help from. So we run to God. We'll never be stranded. A believer will never be stranded. Why? Because we have God as our refugee camp, where we walk with freedom, where we walk joyfully. Those of you who have been refugees, you see the care that is given to you by the United Nations, or even in the camp. Talk of Kakuma refugee camp and how people who are there feel secure because they are taken care of, because somebody is protecting them. Now imagine having God as our refuge. We feel the protective hand of God. We feel like little children who know that all our needs are going to be attended to by our God. And he's coming to us. He's saying, I will be your refuge. He's saying, once I come to dwell in your midst and be the Lord your God, Yoel, the Lord your God, Joel, I become your Joel, then I am telling you, the mountains shall drip sweet wine. Sweet wine. Wine is something that gives joy. Wine represents joy. So it's not just wine, but it is wine with an adjective. It is wine which is sweet. It is sweet wine. Meaning you don't just get joy, but you get joy to the full. Because God himself provides for you. God himself takes care of you. And he's going to do that even to us. As we struggle, as we look at the challenges we are facing today with COVID-19, as we look at the problems we are facing today in our lives, we know very well God will come through. He will come to our aid as he did at the time of Prophet Joel. He will do that. But he's asking us to do one thing, to keep listening to him and making the word of God our source of life. When Jesus was speaking and preaching here, he was talking about Beelzebul, and he was showing his authority as he told people, you know what, I want to tell you, since we were talking about Beelzebul, and now I am accused of using the forces of Beelzebul to heal other people, I want to tell you this. Even you, sometimes you may look clean and all, but there are times that you allow the devil to take over you, and the devil will bring other devils, and you will be in more problems when you allow what people say or think of you to dictate your life. You are going to collapse. Don't allow that. Don't give chance to the devil to overtake you. And as he was preaching like this, one woman got excited and said, oh, blessed the womb that bore you and the breast you suckled. She was so excited. And you can imagine, she was exclaiming by the power of the Holy Spirit in her. And she started admiring, and I suppose having that spiritual jealousy for Mother Mary. But what we see is Jesus saying these words. Rather blessed are those who hear the word of God and keep it. You think Our Lady is blessed? Yes, she is blessed. But she's not blessed because she bore me, because she brought me into this world. She's blessed because she listened to the word of God and kept it. Blessed are you, O Mary, says Elizabeth, because you believed that all that was said by the Lord would be fulfilled. That is where your blessing is, Mary. And that is why we call her blessed. And that is why she was able to sing the Magnificat and say, from now on, all generations will call me blessed. In chapter 1 of Luke, all generations will call me blessed from now on. Why am I blessed? Because I listened to the word of God and kept it. Do you want to be blessed as well? Listen to him as he speaks to you to say, trust in me. I am with you. I will take care of your needs. Listen to him as he says, do not be afraid. I am with you and I will hold your right hand. He says this in Isaiah 41 verse 13. He wants us to believe and trust that he is with us and he will journey with us to the end. We give glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Saturday to you.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me, and I this is my day.